The day has finally come. It is time for a full tour of my realistic tutorial park in Planet Coaster. We will visit the park both during day and nighttime, and of course we will ride all of the coasters and an updated version of my latest addition, the Dark Ride. The idea with this park from the start was to create short tutorials to give ideas and inspiration of how to add realism, where each episode is created around a certain area of a theme park. It ended up being a series with 17 episodes in total, and in case you have missed any episode and would like to catch up at a later stage, I have gathered them all in a playlist that I will put on the screen at the end of this video. This park has a total of 8 flat rides, 1 dark ride, and the following 5 roller coasters: a B&M dive coaster, a wild mouse coaster, a B&M inverted coaster, a Gravity Group inspired wooden coaster, and a B&M floorless coaster. Since this mini tutorial park series has come to an end and the announcement of Planet Coaster 2 has been made, I will shortly start a new park build series with the help of all of the results gathered from the polls I had posted on my channel. I can already reveal that the park will feature a bunch of amazing flat rides and a handful of exciting coasters chosen by you. I am super excited about it, and I hope that you are as well. Now, I will not hold you back any longer. Let's visit the realistic mini tutorial park. The entrance area was built in part 2, and I didn't want to make it as grand as many other park entrance buildings tend to be. I wanted it to be more of a calm place where visitors could relax under the shade with an ice cream before proceeding into the park. After entering the gates, a huge plaza opens up with a stunning view over the many rides and attractions awaiting in the park. It is time for the first coaster. Let's take a ride on this spinning wild mouse. Next up is the B&M dive coaster named Phoenix. This roller coaster was built in part 11 and has 4 inversions and a fairly long, winding track compared to many other dive coasters out there. Buckle up and enjoy Phoenix. Meanwhile, my game decides to take its time for some auto-saving. We are heading in the direction of the B&M inverted coaster called Eclipse. This coaster was built in part 15 and has a total of 5 inversions, all custom-made with an auto-completing method. The layout of the track is pretty compact, which adds to the overall experience since there is a good amount of near misses and tight maneuvers. I hope that you will like this thrilling addition to the park. Passing the triple SNS towers, we are soon at the Gravity Group wooden roller coaster called Raging Timber. This wooden coaster is meant to attract a younger audience since it is fairly tame compared to the rest of the coasters in the park. The layout is staying close to the ground at all times, making its way over and under itself several times. Enjoy! We are soon at the very first coaster added in the park, in part 4. It is a B&M floorless coaster with 5 custom-made inversions and a long, winding layout at the backside of the park. If you are curious about the transit track, queue area and the station, I am covering them in part 6. We have so far checked out the park at daylight. Let's find our car at the parking lot, built in part 1, go home and return in a few hours once the sun has set. And we are back. Let's explore the park at night and of course ride all of the coasters again. This time I will also include the POV of the recent added dark ride. It has been slightly updated from the last time. Let's see if you could spot the difference. Thank you. It is now time to head over to the dark ride from part 17. The name of the dark ride is Around the World. I took the inspiration for the three different themed areas of the ride from cities across the globe. The train departs from an underground station before making its way out on the streets of London. The ride then continues into a Greek fishing village before heading into a palace in Morocco. Remember I said the ride has been slightly updated since last time? Let me know in the comments if you can notice the difference. Don't forget to stay tuned to my channel as I, as mentioned, shortly will introduce a new park build series where I will use all of the data from the previous polls to be able to put together an amazing looking, realistic, decent sized theme park. Here are some more videos you might like.